testing, testing, testing.
Can hear you.
Can you hear me? Yeah, Rock, can you hear us? Rock, can you hear us? Rock can't hear us. You don't hear anything, right? Okay. Rock does not hear anything in our headsets. Wait, so we won't be able to hear him, but you can? Yeah, that's fine. As long as in the broadcast, we can converse. We're fine.
Okay. So we're on the right station, right?
Skender's coming in? All right, Skender's coming in.
Well, give us a countdown. You're the lead guy here.
Really?
Of course.
Welcome to Grand Casino Hinckley here, Flow Boxing. Nice card for you here tonight. I got Mike Letourneau here with Steve Kim and Haseem Rahman. First of four bouts for you tonight. This one here in the junior middleweight division.
And Mike, we're glad to be here at the Grand Hinckley Casino. And Rock, good to see you again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Black Band of Ojibwe and Grand Casino Hinckley present Grand Friday Night Fights. All fights presented by Grand Casino in association with Great Cohen Promotions and David Schuster's Winner Take All Productions. Sponsoring all fights this evening, the law firm of Baxter, Smith, and Shapiro. We fight for you, and by Mark Jarman and TS Capital Investments. In addition to our other aforementioned sponsors, our additional sponsors for bout number three are BodyArmorUSA.com, the number one choice in body armor and protective clothing, by the Church Street Gym of New York City, and the APLS Group. This bout is scheduled for six rounds, junior middleweights. Scoring the bout at ringside, judges Mike Fitzgerald, John Mariano, and Anton Thompson. Our referee is Gary Miswa. Let's introduce our fighters. In the blue corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim, he weighed in at 153¾ pounds. His pro record, 7 wins, 12 losses, 6 wins by knockout. From Kansas City, Missouri, please put your hands together for Ramon Barber. His opponent in the red corner is wearing black trunks with white trim. He tipped the scales at an even 154 pounds. His pro record, an impressive 12 wins, only one loss. All 12 wins coming by way of knockout. He hails from the Bronx, New York. Please welcome Skender Halili.
Boxers, you already see your instructions in the dressing room. Never obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. You guys keep it clean, I'll keep it fair. Touch them up. Good luck.
Let's go, Skender!
Thank you.
Halili talked about using that jab, him and his camp earlier. I'm talking to us, Steve, before the fight, but almost looks like Barber might force him to abandon that strategy fairly early here. Oh.
Well, that might have been a balance shot, but there's no doubt about it. Barber is a physically well-built guy, almost like a powder keg. And one thing Halili needs to do, in my opinion, Rock, I think he needs to create a little bit of distance, doesn't he? Start really taking advantage of that reach advantage he has.
Definitely need to control the distance of the fight. Keep that jab out there, double it, triple it. Then once he get him focused on the jab, then you can drop some right hands and some left hands and some nice combinations. And I think that will prove beneficial for him.
Plenty of action here in the first round. Not waiting long to feel each other out, obviously.
No, there really isn't. Rock, I get the sense that, like, certain fighters, Skender, Halili, his best defense is offense, just leading and initiating the action. I don't think he's ever going to be a guy that's really comfortable with being the counterpuncher and letting a guy bring the action to him.
Yeah, well, that would be a problem. You got to be versatile in this game because you can't always, you're not going to always be the strongest fighter, you're not going to always be the fastest fighter. So you got to really cover all bases. You have to perfect defense. Or you will get exposed in this game.
End of the first, which looks definitely a competitive round. I'd have to give the edge to Halili. Two, starting.
Looking back to 2016, Skender Halili, it was just announced by Ring Magazine, was involved in the round of the year, the round two thriller against Jason Thompson back in May or June at Seneca. Rock, that's one of those awards. You only want to win that once, right?
Oh, he rocked him there. That was real. I think a straight right started that one. Barber definitely felt that. I could see it in his legs.
But going back to that Thompson fight, he was knocked down twice in round number two before ending things with a big right hand. And speaking of a big right hand, he lands one right on the button of Barber. That's the one thing that's evident, Rock. This guy, he has a certain ability to kick with that right hand.
He definitely does. That's the gift of the curse. Oftentimes, a fighter falls in love with his power so much, he tends to forget about other things that's needed in this sport. But today, he seems to be out using the jab, using the distance well, and he seems to be growing. I look at this fight right here. It's like a trampoline fight. You can pretty much... You can go, you can jump leaps and bounds and go further in your career, or you can just flat out fall.
Mm-hmm. 13 fights in, he's 12-1. Rock, I get the sense, though, he's one of these prospects, you've got to go the slow way. I don't see him as a quick developmental type of guy.
Well, that's, you know, it remains to be seen because, you know, all the work is going to happen in the gym, depending on his guys' squad and how the gym work is. You might see a totally different fighter from fight to fight. So one fight, it might just click. He might just get it. And then you'll see that all this work pays off. And he'll be ready to take the next step.
Well, and Barber, with 6 of his 7 wins coming by KO at some juncture here, the way the first 2 rounds are going, definitely this one's going towards a 10-8 round. He's going to need, he might have to rely on that power, which he has in most of his wins, to turn this thing around. But looks like he's recovered from the knockdown.
There you go, Skender. Get loose, baby. That's what I want. I want loose hands. Loose hands. Get loose, baby.
Not a 10-8 round for Halili, but Barber did get his bearings about him and came back, and it you know, seems to be making his way back into the fight, if at all possible, here in the third round.
And we take a look at Barber in his corner. 34 years old, hailing from Wichita, Kansas. His last bout was a 6-round decision loss in October to Fayed Agayev. He's dropped his record to 7-12, but again, he has a very, very long list of good, solid fighters on his ledger, including tonight's main event. Rob Bravo Brandt took him the 6-round distance.
Yeah, and one of the few guys to take Rob Brandt the distance, which... you know, lately, the last couple of years, that very, very few of them have. Rob, I think, has 8 knockouts in his last 9 fights. So definitely has some very good experience with class fighters there. Action right in front of us here. Looks like Barber's getting pretty aggressive this round.
No doubt about it, Barber wants to ratchet up the aggressiveness and try to crowd and smother the taller Halili. Rock, does Halili look comfortable in there for you, to you, first 2.5 rounds?
He actually does look kind of comfortable, except the beginning of this round, he would be allowed to get him on the ropes. I think he's fighting smart. I think his defense is kind of tight. He's mixing his assault with the punches up. He's moving, using good movement. He's not falling into dropping his hands and allowing him to throw precise counter punches. So, I mean, he's looking better in there today, in my opinion.
You know, Steve, I sense there for a second, Barber, if you look, he keeps dropping his hands. I think he might be slightly gassing. It looks like he was trying to throw some haymakers to start this round and might be catching up to him. So if I were Halili, I'd be advised to maybe go to the body.
Mike, I don't think there's any doubt that the pace of Barber from the beginning of round number 3 to now has certainly slowed down. You see what's happening now. There's a little bit of distance, a little bit of airspace that Halili should be able to throw punches from. He's one of these punchers. When he gets an opportunity to unfurl and unlay his arms out at a distance, that's where a lot of his power comes from, right at the end of longer punches. And right here, he's going to be uncomfortable as Barber just leans on him a little bit and kind of bulls in.
Yeah, I think the center of the ring where he is right now is going to be a better spot for him. He's been fighting with his back on the ropes. I think he can definitely land something powerful closer to the center of the ring.
And as you can see on Barber's face, nose is bloodied up now from some of the damage from the hard, heavy hands of Skender Halili. Rock, as you see this round, do you think he's utilizing his jab enough, Halili?
I think he could be using it a little more, but I'm impressed with the fact that he's not going right hand crazy. He got the knockdown. He's still nice and cool. He's just trying to outbox this guy, and then if the knockout comes, it comes. He's not out there looking for the knockout. And as we talk about the jab, he starts to pick it up.
Yeah.
Right on cue.
Caught him coming in with a nice jab there. Showing a little more class there, a little more skill there at the end of that round as opposed to just looking for that right hand.
And we take a look inside the corner, and that is trainer Jason Strout, who has worked with Skender Halili for about 3 or 4 years. They work out of the Church Street Gym in Manhattan, New York. And once again, we talked to him earlier, Rock, and really the goal of Jason Strout is to make Halili, who's a natural-born puncher, more of a boxer puncher moving forward.
I think that's the right game plan. I think that's the right game plan because he can always rely on that power. That's always going to be there. So you're born with that. He has that already. So now let's add more to the arsenal.
Rock, you're a heavy-handed heavyweight. How long did it take you to become a more complete boxer during your professional career?
Well, it actually happened to me in the gym. After my fourth fight, I went the distance, and I was taught the jab. That's the best punch in boxing. And then the second punch in boxing was the jab. So from right there, I started just working on my jab. And I think I had a pretty good jab.
Barber's starting out round four much like he did round three, coming forward. Lily doesn't seem to be backing up to the ropes as much, utilizing that jab as well.
Ooh. And Rock, you were an example of this, and I think Halili fits the bill. Guys with heavy hands, a jab can be a power punch.
And that's I've always voted for having a jab as a power punch because, you know, you got guys that's naturally left-handed or naturally right-handed that lead with their power hand. How is that not a power punch? Then you got guys who get knocked down, bloody people faces up, swell people faces up, but that's not a power punch. A power punch is what it does to you. So if I hit you and drop you with my jab, and you hit me with your right hand, and I don't really feel anything, which one is a power punch?
Now let it go.
It's
let it go. You gotta stay tighter.
Yes, you're qualified as a power
now punch. Now punch.
Just one punch. Punch. Now hook.
There you go.
Barber crowding Halili on the ropes there.
Yeah.
Seems to be the where Barber has some effectiveness when he's got him backed up center of the ring with the reach. And I think overall boxing acumen, Halili seems to dominate that portion of the fight, obviously.
When there is distance and spacing between the two, and you see Halili unfurling that hard telephone pole jab, that's when he really dominates the fight. And you can see it in the face of Barber. He is bloodied and he looked very, very bruised up. And you can see there's a sense of desperation now to his offensive attack.
Oh, definitely. I think Barber knows deep down that he's going to need a knockout to win this fight.
There you go. Get off first, Skender. One, two, three, and a four.
So you got somebody extremely hard, even with the jab. And then when you try to return fire, he's not there. Oh, that's so frustrating.
Nice right by Halili. Earlier he tripled up on the jab. Some short jabs on Barber.
Ooh,
a nice straight right. Oh. Overhand right with about 2 seconds left in the round. I think Barber really felt that.
And Mike, for the first time, you're starting to see a little bit of give in Barber because of the heavy hands of Skender Halili, really starting to grind and really sit down on his punches. For the first time, Rock, I think his power is very apparent to Barber.
So you think the power is starting to bother him? You forgot about the knockdown?
Boy, that's an interesting discussion. What do you think is being said there, Rock?
Well, what he should be telling him is, you know, he's still got a chance in this fight. He still can punch. He had 5-6 weeks to prepare for this fight. Does he want it? Because he's blowing it. And he's allowing Halili to control his fight. You got to get in this fight. You got to use your jab. You got a jab. You got everything he has. Then go out there and execute.
Steve, I would be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if Barber goes for broke this round. He looked a little winded in the corner. I'm not sure what advice they gave him, but I think he knows he definitely needs a knockout to win.
Mike, you could see it in his face. It's a very, very discouraged look. Not that I blame him. There was some heavy leather coming his way from Halili at the end of that last round.
Absolutely.
Oh! Uppercut!
Caught him with a nice uppercut. This one might be over soon.
Stop it.
Gary Miswell should get in there and stop this.
Stop it.
Good stoppage by Gary Miswell. I think he could have gotten in there a little earlier, but definitely Barber was out on his feet.
Rock, we spoke about this. That kid has a lot of flaws, but Halili has the eraser.
Well, he just took the Halili off. It was just, you know, all he feels is he took the Halili off his name. He's only feeling the first part of his name.
A lot of jab, a lot of right hand. Rocky was the uppercut right up the middle that I think essentially ended this fight.
Well, clearly that was a part of the game plan because he's been throwing that punch all night. I thought he did land significant damage with it earlier, and I thought it would be like a uppercut hook that hurt him, but it was a single uppercut. It was just the beginning and the end.
Thompson. He had a third round knockout against Damien Hill November 11th at a fight that we were present for. I think if you're his trainer, Rock, you have to be pretty happy with the fact you've got some rounds under your belt and the emphatic finish.
Not only the round, it's how he competed in the round. He didn't really get hit like that. His defense was sound. His movement was good. He used an assortment of punches. He used the jab. He used the right hand. He used the uppercut. Which that might be punch of this year so far. So, I mean, that was a heck of an uppercut. He timed it right. The timing was perfect. And if he keeps making improvements like this from fight to fight, we might have something special on our hands.
GCP got quickly and decisively.
A diamond in the rough.
5 seconds
of the fifth round as referee Gary Miswell stops the bout. The winner by TKO, Skender Halili.
Interestingly enough, I did not see Halili really use the uppercut in the entire fight until the end there.
Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, it was a lot of jabs, a lot of right hands over the top, and it was, as I like to say, the five hole right up the middle. There's Skender Halili having some words with the ring announcer. Let's see what he has to say.
A few seconds of this round.
I'm going to be honest, he's a really tough guy, and I was shocked he could take those shots, but I really wanted the rounds, and I knew I could finish him when I wanted. He's a tough guy.
Yeah. Take us through that. Now, was it a specific punch? Do you remember? Was it a jab, hook, cross? What'd you do?
Just a right hand. I mean, every time I threw the right hand, he shook a little. So I saw that, and I tried to box a little more. Because at the end, I'm going to need more rounds for bigger fights.
Long way from the Bronx to up to Hinckley, but it's well worth it. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you, sir.
You bet.
Rock and roll train.